Zampatti is an outstanding leader in fashion. She built her empire from the ground up, and she is listed by BRW as one of Australia's wealthiest women. And Carla invited us into her home. She sat down with our very own Ita to celebrate 50 years in the industry.
Years. You know, that is really something. Congratulations.
Thank you, Ita. It just has gone so quickly, I can't believe it.
But has life turned out the way you imagined it had when you opened your first boutique here in Sydney?
It's bigger and better, but at the beginning I would have been quite happy to have a small business making a small group of women happy, and now I make many more women happy. And that if you feel that you're looking your very best, you feel the reaction from people. I think well-groomed people attracts other people. I mean, it's an attractive person to look at. I look at you today and you're very well-groomed, Ita, and you're really nice to look at. And I think
it's my Carla Zampatti outfit.
Exactly. And I think Ita cares about herself.
You didn't have an easy ride getting to the top there, did you? Starting out wasn't all that easy. You had the dream, but then you had to get the money, and that was harder than you thought it might be.
It was very difficult at the beginning, and I had to work harder than I thought I could imagine doing.
50 years ago, banks wouldn't lend money to someone like you.
No. 50 years ago, after my divorce, after I kind of walked away from a marriage without any finance, and I was determined to be independent. I didn't want to be maintained, or I didn't want any kind of that security. So, and the bank manager knew me. That's what astonished me. When I went to him, he said, "I think you'll just get married again. You won't stick to business. You'll get married." Fortunately, I had a very enterprising cousin, Mick Coratti, who loaned me $5,000. He said, "I want you to promise only one thing. Don't go into any partnership. Don't take partnerships.
Do it on your own."
Do it on your own.
Carla grew up in Lavero, a small town in the region of Lombardy in Italy. At the age of 9, she moved with her family halfway across the world to Bullfinch in Western Australia. But her dream of becoming a fashion designer was always in sight. So when you told your father, finally, that you were going to pursue a career, something that he did not approve of, and you said you were going to Sydney with your sewing machine, how did he react?
He didn't know that I was going to pursue my career. I told him when I was about 15 that I didn't want to get married until much later, and he was horrified. I mean, for an Italian father, you bring up a daughter and you find a husband and you get her married as quickly as possible, otherwise she gets into trouble.
And marry she did. Carla's first husband, Leo Schumann, proposed in 1964. They married a year later, but unlike Carla's style, the marriage didn't last. Leo's aggression frightened her. You said that he was a bully, he was aggressive. I mean, were you at risk of domestic violence?
I was. And it's not a nice feeling.
No. So you left and moved on.
I left, which was the most difficult part is that he was in my business. So we had to overcome that. But the best way is just simply to walk away. And I restarted, and life has been a dream since then.
From the darkness, however, Carla found light. She fell in love with dashing barrister John Spender, who later became Australia's ambassador to France after a stint in federal politics. Their marriage lasted 34 years and produced two daughters, both of whom are in the rag trade. 34 years, I think, is a great marriage. I'm not saying it wasn't a great marriage.
I agree.
But there's always people who say, "Oh, well, you know, she's a successful woman. She clearly can't have a relationship." Do you think that's true?
Absolutely not.
Do you think men are intimidated by powerful and successful women?
Some men, but I think if a man is sure about his ability and his strength and he's strong, I don't think he's... I don't think so. What's worth
nothing else but love? What's the best advice you've ever been given?
I think I will go back to my cousin's advice not to have a partner, simply a partner in business.
And what about best advice you could give an aspiring fashion designer?
Remember that it's a business. It's not only a creative force. You have to design something that is you, that you believe in, that you're feeling really strong, because no one will buy it if it looks like somebody else's.
Any regrets?
No, no regrets. I think the difficult times teach you about yourself and teach you about life and make you a more rounded person. And the happy times are just wonderful.
You had a few Carla Zampattis in your wardrobe, Jess.
Oh, you know, she is such an inspiring, iconic Australian woman. She, one of her jackets was the very first one I wore when I read the news. There's something about her jackets that just make you feel
powerful.
So ready to go.
Did she know you'd borrowed it from her?
Yeah.
I love Carla Zampatti. She's so modern. Mm. She always keeps her clothes so modern. Mm.
Yep, she keeps reinventing herself. And Carla Zampatti's inspiring story is told in her brand new book, My Life, My Look, and it is available now in all good and not so good bookstores. So pick it up.